Hello, and welcome back to the two-button game App Inventor video tutorial. This is part two, where we'll be setting up the timer for the app. The goal for this is to set up a timer that counts down from 10 and gives you those 10 seconds to press the button. After that, the game ends. Make sure you're in the designer section, and let's go into components and put in a clock component. Scroll down to sensors, and you'll see a clock. Drag that in. You'll see that it shows up in the non-visible components. This means that it doesn't actually show up on the screen, but it works in the background, and it still shows up in the list of components. Now go into the properties of the clock and uncheck the timer enabled, because you don't want the timer to be running before you press start. And make sure that the timer interval is at 1000. This is 1000 milliseconds, so it means that the timer will fire every 1000 milliseconds, so every 1 second. Okay, now that we've got the timer and its property set up, let's go to blocks. Click in the upper right-hand corner. Here's the previous code that we've done. Now we need to add a few things to the start button block. So when you press start, you want to, well, set the time to say 10 seconds left. We'll count down from there. So see the time here? It was originally set to 0, but when you press start, we'll set it to be 10. And we'll set that to be 10. Go to math, get a number, and instead of 0, set it to 10. And then we're going to enable the timer so that we can start counting down. This is just like what we did for the buttons. Scroll down to clock. And then set clock1.timerEnabled to true, because we want it to be enabled. You can get that from the logic drawer. Okay, now that the start button is all updated, let's code the actual functionality of the clock. Go down to the clock component and pull out when clock1.timer. This timer block fires every time the interval is set. So remember, we set the interval to happen every 1 second. So this block will fire every 1 second until we disable the clock. So whenever the clock goes off, we want to decrease the number of seconds left. Remember, we set it to be 10 up here, so we need to change time.txt. Every time it goes off, we're going to take away 1 from the countdown. This is very similar to what we did here, to where we added 1. Go ahead and see if you can do it yourself. Feel free to pause the video, but I'll go through it right here. Okay, so what you want to do is change the time label. So you want to change its text, so what you actually see, to be what it was previously, minus 1. You can get a minus block from the math drawer. And get the text again, time.txt minus 1, back to math. There we go. But of course, you want the timer to stop once it hits 0. You don't want it to go down forever into the negatives. So here we're going to need an if statement that every time the timer fires, it's going to check if it has hit 0 yet. You can get an if statement from the built-in control blocks right here. All right. And here we're going to check if it's equal to 0. You can get an equal sign from here. And what two things are we comparing? Well, the number we're comparing is the number 0. from math. We're going to check if something is equal to zero. And the something that we want to check is the time, the time.text component. There we go. This checks if the timer has gone down to zero. What do we want to have happen when the timer has gone down to zero? Well, we want to end the game. This means disabling the buttons so you can't press them anymore and add to your score, as well as disabling the timer so that it stops counting down into the negatives. This is very simple. We've done it before. Set player one button dot enabled to be now false instead of true. Same thing for player two button. And the last thing we want to disable is the clock itself. Clock one dot timer enabled to false. Duplicate and put in. All right, now's a great time to test out your app and make sure that the clock and timer component works correctly. Go ahead and connect your app using the QR code or the emulator.
All right, so this is what you should have so far. You'll notice that nothing looks too different, but we've added the non-visible clock component, and now the timer should work. So let's go ahead and press start and see what happens. There we go. You can see that the timer is counting down from 10 all the way down to 0. So as we're pressing, we can get some points. And now, when the timer has hit 0, the buttons are no longer enabled and the timer has stopped counting down. This concludes part 2 of the 2-button game app. Please join me for part 3, where we'll be setting up the CloudDB component, which will let you actually play with multiplayer on 2 different devices and compete against your friends. Thank you.